Hello there, guys and gals. The Welsh Hunter here, back with yet another 100% achievement guide. And this time we are getting it all in Firewatch. Now, this awesome adventure game was developed by Campo Santo, published by Panic, and would usually be available for £15.99 from its release date in 2016. And you're probably wondering why I'm doing a guide now for it. Well, because from the 16th of December 2021, it is free on Xbox Gamepass. So come on for the big one. So anyway, Xbox Gamepass, 16th of December. See you there. But we play as Henry, a rugged, bearded man who leaves all of his problems behind to take a fire lookout job in the wilderness of the Wyoming jungle. Now, this game has beautiful scenery, funny, often poignant, yet also spicy conversations with our supervisor, and just everything about this game is fantastic. Now, what makes it better are the easy achievements, of course. So there are 5 to do with completing the levels, or what's called days in this game, and 5 missable ones, but are all very easily located, so I'll always be pointing out where we are, and what we are doing, and where we are going. So all in all, following this guide, you can get this game done in as little as 1 to 2 hours, and I've also tried going slow, but fast, so you don't have to keep pausing, but we're not just hanging around with our wangs and our lady wangs out. So, with that being said then, let us begin. So obviously, as per usual, new game, and new game. And if you're playing games and you don't know how to start a new game by now, playing games is probably not the best thing for you. But of course, there's obviously a lot of walking. There are a lot of opportunities to get lost. So we'll always, again, try to explain where we are and where we're going. But if not, obviously just rewind the video, you know, if you do end up getting lost. Any dialogue options don't matter here. Basically, we're going through a bit of a story where our beautiful Julia, well, it's a sad occasion, actually. She starts getting, well, you'll see. But again, smash through the dialogue and there's going to be little bits of scenes and things like that where we're hiking and walking. We're just leaving our apartment now and half, basically. I'm just going to spoil it for you because you're going to find out anyway. But basically, our beloved Julia, at 41 years old, has early onset dementia, which is very sad. But instead of being supportive, we just chuck her in a home. I mean, you can if you want. You do get dialogue choices here. I just keep pressing the left one. But for me, I just stick her in a home like Grandpa Simpson and go off into the Wyoming jungle for a couple of months. Very supportive, see? I don't know if it's the beard or the broad shoulders or what. That's got nothing to do with anything, but here we go. So to walk forward, obviously press left on the left stick, and also you can click in the left stick to start doing the little Usain Bolt sprint of life, which will always come in handy to make the game go a little bit faster. But in terms of story and everything, we're not hanging about for the story. I will be speaking to our supervisor, Delilah. That's my kid's name. On the radio. So we are getting a bit of story, but, you know, again, the dialogue choices don't matter. They don't affect any achievements. It's just if you want to be a butthole or, you know, you want to try and get on your supervisor, which normally happens in every single job. Not every single job, of course. Now, get ready for the sexiest drawing you will ever see in your life ever. Oh my god, we just seen hairy bows and hairy penis. Oh, I am child. I'm still the ones that, I am still one of those that, you know, when 15-year-olds in high school draw penises in, you know, in the books and everything, that's me. 31 years old. So not childish. Yeah, anyway, every time we get to these bits, just keep walking forward. Every one of these paths are linear until we basically finish the story in regards to our dementia'd up wife. And now here we are then. Now we're going to start playing the game properly. So that's just 5 minutes of storytelling just to see that, you know, what a wonderful guy that we actually are. We're like, well, sorry you got to go through this, but, well, I'm going to go and try and get another people now and just get a new job. No way. Okay, thanks, B. So, obviously, what we'll be doing is going up and down into our lookout tower quite a lot. So grab the radio with the right trigger. Obviously, we can press the A button to jump over things, as you would have already seen, and the right trigger to interact with things. So look at the generator switch behind you there. Press the right trigger, get close to it. Use the right trigger button, and everything comes on. And then what's going to happen? Normally, you'll have, if Delilah speaks to you, you can then press the left trigger to reply. Press the left trigger again, and then the right trigger to go down to the dialogue options. And then just release the right trigger to pick whatever specific dialogue option you want. I've just put the subtitles on there because this is a very walkie, talkie, stalky kind of game. And you'll see what I mean by stalky in just a bit. But anyway, have a look around, enjoy some stuff. Apparently I start throwing things out because why the hell not? But all we're doing is just talking to a Big Del right here.
Then can I sleep forever?
Sure, buddy. Okay, now go ahead.
Okay, you're probably just rebelling against a mom who wishes you had given her grandkids, by the sound of your voice, at least 15 years ago. You come out here and it really grinds her gears and you love it. Can I sleep now?
Well, she also says I fuck immature men, but in my defense, who wouldn't want a 28-year-old with ambition and energy and some fire in his belly in bed?
Me. I'm going now.
Just a second. Now it's my turn.
Okay. Good night. Bye.
Let's see. I don't know anything about you. I say you got fired from your job and have finally decided to write your novel. That's the sort of bullshit reason you'll find a man out in the woods.
Good night.
Welcome to the job.
Hey, did she just say she'll do any immature men? I'm an immature man. I'm just joking. Very mature. I mature like a fine cheese cheddar wine, whatever the friggin' saying goes. Whatever the saying goes. Anyway, we all know I'm mature. You've obviously watched my videos. You know I'm super mature. Anyway, so remember to, again, you don't have to speak to Delilah here if you don't want to, or at all if you don't want, unless you are forced to. But of course, it's always nice to have a look at the story and try and simp on her while she simps on us. As you'll see again in just a bit. So anyway, what she's going to basically do is just show us the map table here in the middle of the room. So we do need to interact with the map table before heading out. So, there it is. So again, remember the left trigger and the right trigger to pick any dialogue options and then just release all your fingers. Stop fingering your control. Dirty perv. And there we go. So we can have a look at the window. There's fireworks going off, which of course, you know, apparently is illegal in the 1989 Wyoming wilderness. F me. Well, Delilah's very quick, isn't she? Thank you very much, but no thank you. So, now we're going to finally start seeing what the game's all about. You can actually leave right now. You don't actually have to wait until Delilah speaks and yammers on for a bit. We can actually leave right now. But for whatever reason, I'm still wondering why I'm not leaving.
Just make sure they don't do it again. Take their shit.
All right, fine.
Don't feed anyone a knuckle sandwich. Get going. You'll probably need a rope to get down the shale between you and the lake, if I remember right. There should be one in the supply box on the way. The code is 1234. It's actually that for all of them.
Secure.
Shut up.
Ah, so, again, we could have left by now, but for whatever reason I didn't. But now we can leave, so press the right trigger to open the door. And we're going to start heading down. So, you will see a lot of these, we are going to go down a lot of the same paths a lot through this game, but it does get easy to get lost. So, from here, what we can do again, if you ever get lost, you can always press up on the D-pad to read the map, and then press the left bumper to zoom in, just to see where we are if you do get lost. I don't bother with it because I'll just show you where we're going anyway. So as we head down the path, head slightly to the left. We're just going through these trees. and up over this little hill right here and between these rocks. Go right ever so slightly. Try not to get lost, stuck in the trees like a donkey, like I was, and head slightly left, and we're going to see our first supply cache. So every supply box, the password is always the same, 1234, so just interact with it by pressing the right trigger, 1234 for everything. So yeah, it is easy to get lost, even though we do go down the same path, so always just check out sort of what I'm seeing and have a look at the environment in terms of, are we going past the same rock? Are we going past the same set of trees, etc., etc.? So you can update the map as well if you want to, if you're planning on using that. Otherwise, you're just going to grab the rope with the right trigger. And, well, let's just say we're not going to do the thing that Logan Paul can come in, find us and laugh about it like a complete asshat that he actually is. God damn, I hate those Paul brothers. Anyway, we're just going to head basically straight from the supply box through these set of rocks just slightly to the right there. And we're just going to keep heading sort of straight down now, rather than right. I went through the trees for whatever reason, but we're just heading straight. So another quite a few things of these we're going to see throughout the game. Press the right trigger to stick your rope in the hook. Press the A button then to rappel, and the left stick to go all the way down. Very conveniently placed rocks for us, and very convenient that we don't have to go searching or buying any of the rope hooks. They're already there for us, which is nice. Again, try not to fall, because that shit hurt. And if that shit hurt, then you can't do your job properly and hit on your radio, apparently. Oh, supervisor, you look so hot in the distance. Wee, wee, wee. Anyway, again, you can report these things. You don't have to, pressing the left trigger to get the radio up. You can, you can't. Really doesn't make a difference. But we're heading straight, slightly sort of to the right. You can see the sun in the distance if you're wondering where we are. I mean, you can probably see, but just in case you've managed to get lost. But keep heading straight past all these rocks for the time being. And we've stumbled onto a party! Awesome. Oh, hello, hello, hello. We have little Brazia. Oh, Nicky's on the floor. Anyway, keep following this little dirt track. We've got a bras and knickers and... Oh my gosh, hello, hello, hello. So, my respect for women has gone up. Any woman that skinny dips, my respect to you for getting your boobs in that water is extremely cold. If I went skinny dipping in that water, my already small pecker would be basically impossibly tiny to see. So that's why I don't bother doing it. Anyway, you don't have to watch them. Stop being a perv, you disgusting pervs. Turn behind you from where the water is, and there is this log that we can climb across. And we can, again, we'll just keep going straight. Don't call me a skeezer. My name is Geezer Pleaser, not Skeezer Pleaser. We're just going to keep following the water for now anyway, and I'm wondering how many men have actually just about to nip onto a little bit of Pornhub rather quickly to go, women skinny dipping in the search section, women skinny dipping, and then of course you've got Big Johnny from Brazzers appears out of nowhere, and well, everyone who knows, if you knows, you knows. Anyway, thanks for the ad there, friend. But again, we're basically just going straight for the time being. There you go. Now it's telling us we can use the left bumper to zoom. Even though we could have done with that earlier if you didn't know. But just keep heading straight and keep listening to Big Delilah's problems, as it were.
I know, I know I can get a little pushy, you know, putting you on the spot about why you're out here and stuff.
And you thought it was a good idea to get into your love life, I guess you'd call it?
Yeah. Anyway, I'm sorry.
It's fine.
I'll keep that sort of a thing to a minimum.
When we get here, just go slightly to the right. You can see the supply box already. So again, whack that boy open. 1, 2, 3, 4. Nice and secure, just in case anyone ever wanders into a forest and comes across these supply boxes, always try 1, 2, 3, 4. Because screw it. Again, you can copy the information again if you want. But like I said, I'm not going to be using the map a lot, but it's obviously always good if you do. So pick up the flashlight and any other dead animal bits if you want, depends on what it is. Go ahead, blind yourself. Turn the flashlight on by clicking in the right stick and head through this cave. Again, these caves are usually pretty linear, but if we head to the right here and then to the left, you can already see some rocks to climb up. So yeah, any caves that we go in, they're usually pretty linear. Small, small caves, so nothing to worry about if you'll get lost. I turn Scottish. And so, cue. Right, at this point, we're going to climb up one of these rocks, and there's going to be a figure that's watching us. Now, when we're going to head to the right and start basically just climbing up this hill, going up and up and up. Sometimes the light may follow you, other times it may not. And at this point, you can always... Oh, there. You may be speaking to Delilah again at this point, and you may not. So if you don't, literally don't panic about it again, because it doesn't harm any achievements in any way. It's just a bit more for extra bit of story. So head right, rather than going straight up this sort of mud path. And just keep going up the only one path there is. And fair play to our bearded Henry Big Dog dude. He can hike with the bloody best of him, can't he? Because I'm already knackered. I'm just knackered talking, to be honest. Let alone friggin' walking and talking. Ah, who's got time to walk and talk? Climb up, climb up, climb up. Why is it always funny when someone falls over? Like, even the littler the fall, the funnier it is. Anyway, just head straight a little bit and ever so slightly to the right. You could probably just start seeing our lookout tower. So nip up there. Nice little bit of conversation with Delilah. And on to the next day.
Someone broke in.
They what?
They wrecked the place. Threw my typewriter out the window. Motherfucker!
Holy shit. I'll let the Forest Service know what happened.
Okay, thanks.
Do you have any idea who would have done this?
Maybe that guy I saw in the canyon, but I don't know why the fuck he'd want to mess with my stuff.
Well, I'll have the rangers keep an eye out for a man hiking on his own and question him if they find him. I can't believe someone would do this. I worry about bears and fires, and that's about it. And now I've got to worry about some deranged hiker going after lookouts? Great. Okay, in the morning I'm gonna call my friend Patty, who works the desk down in Cody. They keep a list of everyone who's officially been in and out of the trailhead since, I don't know, forever, and see if we can get a list of names. We won't get much, but at least if anything else happens, we can refer to it and see if anything comes up.
Thanks.
I need you to feel safe out here.
Don't worry about it.
Oh, you can protect yourself, huh?
I just don't worry about it.
Perfect. Keep that attitude up, and you'll have an excellent summer. Wake up! Hey, wake up!
I'm awake. What's your problem?
Our problem.
Sorry, our problem.
That storm knocked out the phone line I used to talk to the service, which means we're cut off. I tried radioing out, and that's not working either.
Good morning, everyone, from Brickleberry. If you haven't seen the show Brickleberry, go watch it. It's hilarious. Anyway, I say Brickleberry is the same sort of thing here. So anyway, as we head down, head to the right, and just go straight until you get to this sort of wide open area-ish. Have a look at the big rocks in front of you, and then there's just sort of... Stick with the rock on the left-hand side, and we will see this big drop-down. So, give it a drop-down. Down, down, down your pants. Drop it down your pants, but don't put live fire ants down there. Oh, God, no. Thanks rhymes with Hank. Does it? Well, there we go then. Eminem's got something for his new single. Anyway, all we're doing is just heading down at the minute. Only this one sort of way to go for a mo. Head to the left here. Keep heading down over the bridge. And far away, Teletubbies come to play. Okay, there is this weird secret gate on the left there, but we're going to come back to that later, so head up, straight, left, and we're going to end up back outside. So again, nothing else to do except enjoy the cold morning fog. That's definitely not Silent Hill stuff, is it? No. Just press the right trigger there to clear this bush. Give it a shave as well if the bush is too large and it sort of gets down your throat. And, you know, you're picking leaves out your mouth and stuff. We're on about the same thing, right? Red. Anyway, keep heading down and up over the hill. So just heading past this rock we just went past, go slightly left there, up towards the big telephone pole, and head slightly left again. And then just follow it down. Again, the paths are quite linear, but so it can be very easy to get lost. Go to the left here, just past the sign, until you can see this sort of log on the floor. So as long as you see this log, you are on the right path. Keep heading straight again. Usain Bolt sprinting for your life. Just keep following the path down here, slightly again to the right. And then we're going to start heading up. So from this point, let's just go keep going straight a minute, and then we're going to start turning left just past these rocks on our left, all the way around left, and we're coming up to our first missable achievement. So you see the supply box, we don't actually need that, but if you turn right around the opposite way from where the supply box is, on this rock, you can see a little turtle on it. So press the right trigger to pick it up, press and hold the B button to adopt it, and oh, look at the little happy guy. No, he will. I don't know where you put him. Have you just put him in your ass pocket? Or your ass? Hopefully it's the pocket, because sticking a turtle in your butt, well, that doesn't go right. Anyway, I need to see a doctor. Urgent. So head back down and then head to the right. Again, we're going to see a whole bunch of rock formations in front of us. Probably doesn't really help. Because there's a lot of rocks in this game. But we'll basically just keep going straight for the time being, and at the end of it we should see another rock that we can climb on. So it's basically from where the turtle was, right back down, and then right instead of left where we came that time. So head down, and then this time all we need to do is go right all the way up this hill until we see the telegram pole or the telephone wire pole, whatever the hell it is, at the top. I get, again, like I said, it is easy to get lost and a bit confused. I thought it was that one, but no, we just head up all the way to the top of the hill. And then we can start turning left and heading back down it. See, I wouldn't steer wrong, except I have 1,000 times and I'm sorry about all of them. God damn. Head straight rather than keeping going down, and then we could do another big drop down. Again, Henners has some massive cankles if he can't even feel the pain from that. That's a long way down. And I'm scared of heights. Where? So head straight for the time being.
I think I just saw you at the top of Beartooth Point. Was everything okay up there?
Nope. Those drunk dumbasses cut the comms wire and left a pair of their white...
So when we drop down, we're going to turn to the left.
I'm sorry, what?
And keep heading down this linear path again. Over the log and far away... Oh my god, is that my pecker? Well, it came out to play. Just joking. We're going to have a look at this hanging backpack. Right trigger this a couple of times. We're also going to be doing another missable achievement now with this camera. So this is Brian Goodwin's bag. Now, he's going to be a major player later on, so remember the name, Brian Goodwin. So press the right... what we can do with this camera then, we basically need to take all 18 pictures. So press right on the directional pad to whip the camera up, right trigger to take the pictures. There is a point in just a little bit. We're just going to head down this rope hook and go down. But basically, we're going to find a camp where the girls, these skinny dipping, naked girls were skinny dipping. They basically left a little tent, a little campfire and everything. What, and basically Delilah's going to ask a question about the camera. Now, if you are really deeply into the story, you can start talking about the camera and get more story-related stuff. But that involves not taking all the pictures. If you just want to get the achievement out the way like I do here, press right on the D-pad and keep clicking the right trigger until it's all done. And the achievement unlocks. But if you want a bit more of the story, don't take any of the pictures yet. Go to the tent and the campfire, and then Delilah will ask a couple of questions. Not sure what they are, but again, that's if you are well into the story and want a bit more. So, heading just down, there was two ropes that we just headed down. Again, reply if you want to. Again, doesn't make a difference if you don't, but we're just basically going to keep heading straight. And I think it is at this point I whap out our disposable camera. It's always worth doing it now, because you will actually miss the achievement. So, either do it now, or when I do it in just a little bit before we get to the campfire. So, yeah, there we go. So, we're doing it now. Right in the D-pad, press them all, and just keep going straight. For now, we're just going to head up this little rockle of cockle. Rock-a-doodle-doo. Nice, I love talking to you. Heading down and then basically just heading straight past this rock and log on the left and heading through all of these prickly boys. Now fair play again to Henry for not squealing like a little bitch when hitting all these prickly boy spiky trees, because I bet that shit hurt. But again, just whack out all of your camera, all of the pictures. Again, if you do end up missing it, if you do start the next day, it is an autosave, so you will miss it. But luckily, it's less than half hour in the story if you do miss it. So you shouldn't, but we're all good. So it is just a case of going straight. Henry, stop simping on our friend Delilah. She's our supervisor. Thank you very much. Find this rock to drop down. You've got to tell her about Julia and that you left it behind because you're an awful, awful man. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying?
Night vision.
Incredible.
Why, thank you very much, Governor. I'm having a hell of a time getting this fucking flapjack off his ass and out to repair that wire.
Oh, man.
What? Do you like that? This guy is the freaking king of the flapjacks.
Yeah, that's solid. I'll have to keep that one in my pocket.
It's all yours.
So this is basically just one big straight line, and honestly, this game came out in 2016. It still looks so ridiculously beautiful all around. It's just a really nice looking place. Wouldn't want to get trapped here, mind, 172 hours style, and have to cut off my arm or cut off my testicles to get free from somewhere. Well, how are your testicles getting jammed in between two rocks? Aha! It's not bear worth thinking about, honestly. Ah, flub. Right, so, we got to now find the source of the smoke. Don't know why Delilah's not doing all of this, but, you know. There we go. So, see this log on the left? Head towards the left. And sort of keep hugging the left-hand side rock. Keep going straight through all these bushes. Basically, we are on the way back. So, heading through these bushes, we now end up at the lake. And now we can just go to the left and start following the little dirt track. So that is important for this bit, because this bit can be quite confusing to get out of, but just keep following the mud path, all the way around, and you should see the log for us to climb underneath. And lovely, just keep going straight through the beautifulness of this forest. Again, try not to get your testes jammed in between two rocks, because... Anyway, keep heading right, well, I say it's slightly right, but keep on going straight. We are on our way back to the lookout tower. Go over these, basically over these rocks there. Until we find the little rope hook that we can nip down.
You know, if it makes you feel any better, you're a member of a diverse club of lookouts that have come to the thoroughfare after...
Now, when you're trying to answer Delilah, again, it's so easy to get lost when you're trying to concentrate on one thing and walk at the same time. When we're here, keep heading right, just keep heading towards the sort of mud path in between these two big rocks. So, like I said, it can be super easy just to be, when you're trying to figure out what to say and Delilah's asking us a question again, it's so easy to get lost. Happened to me a couple of times later on in the video. So heading right through the lush woods, sticking with a big rock on the right, make sure you're just sort of hugging that, heading through the trees. Again, looks bloody beautiful, mate. Looks bloody beautiful. Definitely ideas of people... This is the idea of heaven for a lot of people. Oh, including myself. Nothing about... no wieners or anything about. No people to piss you off. It's just awesome. But anyway, of course, we are about, and I love people, and no one pisses me off. So as we head down here, head right down the stream, and you can just see the waterfall in front of us. And head to the right again. We're going to be going under these rocks. Like I said, nobody pisses me off, because... I love bringing out these achievement cards for you. Just people on the roads that are assholes. Especially those in BMWs and such. Anyway, here we are then. We have finally found the teens' campfire. So we're going to interact with the tent. And we're actually going to be grabbing the note off of it. Again, to keep it, just press and hold the B button. Or you can press Y to read it if you want. So, so basically the girls... All of the girls' clothes, of course, they went skinny dipping. The mysterious figure that we've seen have obviously stolen them, had a little sniff of them, the dirty bitch. Disgusting. But obviously, you know, they think that we did it. So, you know, no, I'm just a nice guy, I swear. So anyway, nothing else is happening. We're just talking to Delilah until the new day starts. So think about what's going on.
Weird stuff happens in the woods. It could be other campers. They could be having a bad mushroom trip. We really don't know, but they're gone. There's no way to call the cops. They're not coming back, and we can get to work. I'd really like to start enjoying a quiet summer.
Yeah, me too.
So welcome to day 3 then, after only 2 days of being here and being broken into, we've now got to do all the work, which is friggin' annoying. So head down, and we just need to find a couple of pieces of wood. So the first one, well, it's directly in front of us there, but we're just going to grab the one basically underneath the staircase, so from just behind you. I am Tom Cruise, if I had a good looking twin, and I wasn't in the closet. Tom Cruise came out the closet now. Or I'll pull out my gun. Again, if you know, you know. Anyway, the second piece of wooden plank is right by the stairs and the one just at the bottom of the stairs there. So, 3 pieces of easily wooden board that we can find. Go upstairs, give that a fix, and again, if you're Tom Cruise, why not you coming out the closet now? So you can just go away. I'm not coming out the closet. Again, if you know, you know.
Tuxedos as often as possible.
Oh, really?
You bet.
How cosmopolitan. I didn't realize Boulder was so chic.
It is the peak of high society.
Good to know, Dale, yes. Now tell me about your face. I'm looking at you across the bar. What do I see?
A pretty thick beard.
Oh, have you always had a beard?
For a while, yeah.
All right, perfect. I want to know about your eyes.
Get out of here.
I'm drawing you. I need to know.
Your what?
Is that okay? Don't answer. I'm gonna do it regardless.
Fine.
Your eyes, tell me.
They're happy, I think. I mean, I've been told they look happy.
Aw.
Look, I don't know how to describe eyes.
Happy is good. That's good. Okay, got it. Thank you, Henry.
You get what you need?
Absolutely.
Oh, and that window is all patched up. So, what should I do now? What's next?
What's next? What do you think is next?
Well, you've been the one giving me tasks for 2 days straight.
What's next is you sit in that room until September 1st and call me at the first sign of smoke.
Oh, yeah.
Why don't you let me know when you're mentally prepared for that task, and I'll give it to you.
Okay, I think I am ready to tackle my long-term commitment of keeping this national forest safe from total destruction.
I am glad to hear you've really thought this through.
Of course.
We've issued you a comfy chair to sit in and everything.
You know, it's not really that comfy. I mean, it's wooden and there's no padding. I think I actually got a splinter in my thigh this morning.
Aww. Well, regardless, take a seat. The forest depends on you.
No gameplay on day 9. We're just enjoying a cardboard sandwich in the setting sun.
Hello,
beautiful.
Henry. Having a nice afternoon?
I might never leave.
Well, I called with some bad news. Two young women, Chelsea Stevens and Lily McLean, were reported missing. They've got parents out in California who haven't heard from them in a week. They were supposed to meet an aunt down in Cody. If they're the girls from last week, then you're probably the last person to have seen them.
You should tell whoever that I'm happy to be questioned.
Look, it's not going to be an issue. I mean, if they turn up dead, then maybe. Should I just not say anything and save us the trouble?
Yeah, don't.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking. All right, Henry, thanks. Enjoy the sunset.
Until, of course, Delilah just ruined it by telling us those two girls never turned up and we are in the frame. Awesome! That's... We haven't been out here 2 weeks yet. So, let's do what Delilah says then. So, get out of bed, pick up the radio right in front of us.
What do you want?
And we're going to have a chat with our beloved. The other one who's lost her mind, beloved. Ooh, awkward. Anyway, this is all that's happening for this bit anyway.
I am.
Are you having a nice time?
Yeah, it's good here. It's beautiful, you know?
That's great, Henry. Really great. Well, I'll let you get back to sleep then.
Okay, Jules.
Delilah seems nice.
Mm-hmm, sure.
Bye, baby.
Now, is it just me, or is calling one another baby just completely cringe? I'm sorry if that's what you do, but all the power to you, but... Hey, baby. Oh, yeah, baby. Hey, baby. It just... to me. But again, all the power to you if, you know, you call each other baby and say that roar is I love you and dinosaur and all that shite. Right, so head through the prickly boys. Again, I just kept walking into them for some reason. Maybe it's just because Julia called me baby. Nah. Head slightly to the right and climb up this rock. And then we're going straight. There is a left and right that we can go. What we are doing is heading to the right. Ever so slightly to the right and straight through the trees. Doesn't make too much of a difference. We should end up in the same bit here anyway. Nice tree on the left, big rock formation on our right. And then slightly to the right, you can see a big steep thing with a rope to climb up. So nip your ass up, boy.
Marijuana to function. Hey, so who's Jules?
She's... Wait, did I tell you about her?
No. Not exactly.
Then how?
A couple of weeks ago, you called me in the middle of the night, and you were...
And then from here, go to the right slightly and go over this log. All we're doing here is just grabbing a bit of grubs. But for some reason, they put it all the way out here, which is annoying. Kind of a linear path. And by the way, I know why Delilah gets it hand-delivered to her, because she's got them big nips, of course. So if you got big nips, all good. So you're going to see this gap in the fence, but we're going directly to the left before we get to the fence, up this little bit of hill, and there is the food supply crate. So again, 1, 2, 3, 4, interact with the middle one and wait for the conversation to die down.
Care of back in Australia, because that's where she's from. She's there. And that's it.
I'm so sorry.
Yeah.
Henry, listen. My God, I'm so sorry you've gone through that. I don't know if you've thought of it this way, but... her family is taking care of her, and you need to take care of you.
All right. I got everything I need out of here. Time to chow down.
Just yours, right?
Who do you think I am?
So we've been here about 2 months now. I think we're getting on pretty well. I think everything's going good. So again, nothing more than just having a look at the smoke. Now this is the part where we and Delilah get kind of simpy towards one another. We haven't seen each other, but we start simping and touching ourselves over each other's voices, which is... Now, I know you're going to touch yourself over my voice, that's fine. It's just common practice these days, huh? 8,000 new looking at it? Yeah. Maybe not. Anyway, all we're doing, again, is just having a little chat for now until the next day starts. I'll just retract what I just said earlier on. So
I was kidding.
No, you were not. You're sweet, but we can't call it the Delilah Fire.
Okay, what then?
How about my middle name, June?
The June Fire, even though it's July.
I like it. So there's this creek down the hill, and, you know what my favorite thing to do is?
What's that?
I love to take a bottle of whatever I have on hand, plunge it deep into the water, and let it chill in there all day. And then, on nights like tonight, when it is so disgustingly hot, I have something nice and cool to drink. I learned that from my sister in Santa Fe. She'd do that with a bottle of tequila near her house and make margaritas the size of your head. You'd like it there.
If I was there with you, I'm sure I would like it a lot.
Are you looking at the fire?
Yeah, I am.
I love how they look at night. During the day, it's just smoke, but when the sun is down, you can just get lost.
Yeah.
I'm glad you're here.
Me too.
Good. I don't talk to the other lookouts as much as I talk to you. Not in the same way. I know it's probably been a while since you've connected with someone the way we have. I don't mean to get all heavy, but it's been really nice. I wish I was over there.
I wish you were too.
We could sit outside. We could talk without these radios. We could, you know...
What? What could we do?
Well, let me tell you.
Ooh! well, let me tell you. Why couldn't we find out the conversation? So, now we're getting really, this is another heavy episode of the Simpsons. So anyway, after a night where we don't know what each one another looks like, and we, well, apparently I reckon we touched ourselves, we can now go fishing. So we're going straight. For now, basically we're going, if you remember earlier, there was a bra on that tree earlier on, there's not now, because that weirdo perv stole him. Have a look through the mud path, we're going to end up by the lake. But this is where the game starts getting a bit trippy and a bit weird, so pick up the clipboard. You can drop the fishing rod if you want, or you can just press the B button to stick it in your back pocket, evidently. Do that with the clipboard, though. Keep hold of the clipboard. Don't need to pick up the fishing rod. Just turn around, have a look at this log on the floor on the right-hand side, and go straight until we go over the next log. And basically, there's going to be a radio. You can probably just see it in the distance on the rock. There it is. So as soon as you stop talking, we're able to pick up the radio, and we get it knocked the flub out, boy.
Wait, hold on. Something's out here.
Henry, I'm worried. You didn't find an Eden. Henry, are you there?
I mean, it's a fair old whack, isn't it? That's a fair old whack to get knocked out for a bit. Oh, holy hell, I got hit in the head. That is a steel fist. Anyway, go across the log, and then we're basically heading back towards where we came from, sort of where the lookout tower is. So again, follow with this mud path. Go across all the bushwas under Bra Log. That's what the log's called now, Bra Log. Right. So instead of heading to the right, there's going to be a left coming up where we're going to go. So you can see the big rock formation in front of us and the trees on the right here. So just keep heading sort of towards these trees, just through them. And then now we're going to start heading left. You just see where the mud path sort of branches off a bit? Head to the left here. And what we're going to do right in front of us, there should be another rope to climb. Dexter, Henry Dexter, whatever, big, rugged, beefy lumberjack man. Well, he's having some problems.
You saw Henry. Maybe you pissed off some more campers and they came back to sucker punch you.
Look, I know what I saw. Hey, it was our words with initials for our names, H and D, clear as day.
And you've been feeling okay?
I feel fine.
Okay, I'm sorry, I believe you, but that conversation was from 2 weeks ago.
I know they were.
So proceed straight just past this log on the floor, and then we're going to take an immediate right. So just past this rock, take a right. Again, you can just about see the mud path, and then head up straight and go to the left, sort of where the rock is on the left, on our left hand side, and just keep bashing it through the trees for a second, and again just keep heading to the left. So here we are. And then we can sort of just keep heading right now. So we're getting this path slightly linear, but again, bloody easy to get lost. So go to the right now instead of going straight up. And then just keep it going right. Don't even go left, and you should see this little fence right here for us to nip down by. And again, we're going to the right, so straight through the gap in the fence. Underneath this log. And just keep it heading down. Now we should be by the other side of the lake, more or less. So what we can do is just jump on this first rock. And I do end up jumping on the second rock, but we can actually just take a right now and go to the other side of the mud path. There we go. So we get there eventually. And we've got a supply box, which we're not actually going to nip it on. Ned Red. Have a look through this burned forest. And just keep on heading straight through. Job done. Now we're sort of back at the lush meadow, so stick again to the sort of left-hand side of this path. And there's a snowmobile, a couple of snowmobiles there. One has been abandoned and looks pretty fudged up. Otherwise, just keep nipping it straight. Ignore the big whale-looking dong rock on the right-hand side. Just keep going straight for a second. This is pretty much the end of this day. Not a lot of walking left to do. So just head up. There we go. And we should see the long drop down. So, again, somehow not breaking your ankles, but we are doing a long drop down. So, keep on going straight. And you can see like a little fence just there. But if we head to the left and up over this rock and this big hill, you can see an even more fences. So, head around this particular fence. And we're into some sort of abandoned camp or something. Grab the memo. And again, just press and hold the B button to keep that. Have a look and grab the axe out of this tree to the right of where that memo was. We are going to be needing the axe of life for a couple of life situations. Then just head straight underneath here. And to the right, just the opposite side of where all the benches were. Follow this mud path to the right. And we're going to see this damaged tree we can chop down and hoppity-bop-bop over.
Let's hear it.
You heard someone in the bushes.
Yeah.
Okay, so let's assume we're being tailed. Or you are, at least. Where are you right now?
Just on my way back, in and out of trees, in the middle of nowhere.
Do you see anybody?
No, definitely not.
All right, so tell me what you think of this. Did you just cough?
No. Did you just cough?
No.
Oh, fuck.
Oh, fuck.
There isn't any way someone, like, another lookout could be on this line, is there?
No. Not without tapping our radios. Get in your tower, shut the door, don't leave, and don't use your radio. I'll call you. Understand? I will call you.
And here we are then, day 77. So basically we've only got a couple of days left until we get home. Again, a little bit of dialogue is going to happen here. It starts, sadly, basically going to Scheisenhausen between us and Delilah now. Just when we're starting to get the pure legs and our hairs back there. Still. Anyway, soon as we're up and we can, we're going to head out of the door by pressing the right trigger. You should get the achievement for completing day 76. And we're going to be getting a couple of missable achievements. It's been a while since we've got a missable achievement, but we're going to grab one. We're going to grab three, actually, in day 77. So, head down, and then head to the right. Not all the way to the right, mind you. Just to see this sort of little bit of open planscape. Or open field or whatever. And you can see the rock on our left. We're going to head down with the rock on our left hand side. Until we can drop down. Now there's going to be more conversation with Delilah happening for you right now. But I edited it out because like a dummy I went the wrong way. Which is pretty unlucky and stupid on my part. So you will be talking to Delilah. But just try and keep on going where I'm going. So head to the left. And then we're just basically going all the way down the old mud path right now. So, only one way to go, and we're dropping down. Like, apparently, I'd be shitting myself personally anyway, but pass the gate on the left, then head left this time, so we can go out. It's basically the same path as earlier on, but because so much has happened since then and everything's a bit darker, it can't, again, it confused me first time, but head to the sort of right, weird frick-ass noise. Crap me up the first time playing it, I'll be honest. Just keep heading to the right and down. And then for now we can just head up straight in front of us.
Someone trying to get you to radio about a loud noise so they know where you are.
Ah, fuck.
How about you don't do that again?
So following the linear path, you're going to see this sign directly in front of us right now. So we need to go to Thoroughfare Point. So head to the right from where the sign was. And basically just, it's more or less a straight line because we're going to see the cabin. There it is directly in front of us. So we're going to nip inside the cabin. Again, something abandoned and creepy. Yeah, why not? Let's just go into it. Cold morning fog, Silent Hill style death. Head down the stairs when the door sort of collapses by itself. Again, you can pick up and have a look at some items in here, but the main thing we need is the old stove. Open that up. We're going to have Raccoon Reynolds just destroy us. You little rat. You little vermin piece of crap. But what that does is give us the life and times of Raccoon Carter. That is definitely the next Netflix show. I can tell you where it gets so popular it gets cancelled after one season. Netflix style. So, anyway, head back out of the house and we can go basically back to where the big sign was, so more or less just straight out in front of us, where the cabin was. And on the main path, you can see there is the sign, just to the right of us. Hello, hello. And this time, keep going straight. We're going in the opposite direction this time to carry on with the story. So head to the left when you see the little fork between the rocks there. And again, get out your shaver. We're going to be whapping out the bush. And get out the blocked trail as well. So again, just pressing the right trigger on both of them will do fine, just fine. That's fine. So we've got a couple of things here. The most important one, you can keep the note if you want, but the most important one for another achievement is the cassette tape. So pick that up, press and hold B to put that in your pocket. That will unlock you the old Shaw achievement. So head back the way we came through the bush and everything. At this point, we're going to go slightly right, but sort of stick with the rock on the left-hand side and then go straight down until you can see the telegram pole in front of us. But we're going right this time. And then just sort of heading down the sort of linear path now. So again, you've just seen the achievement get edited out. That's, again, because I went too far to the right and just got lost and stuck in between bushes, which is usually every man's dream, but not this time. Not this time for old henners. Anyway, this is where we should be then. We're going to be sticking with the left-hand side, going sort of up this little raised hill with a bunch of trees. Again, I am trying to explain what is in the environment, so you're sort of on the same path in case you're getting lost. Go to the left until we see, again, you got this log on the floor, which is going to go past, and a little bit of this stream. So this bit is just a nice little walk down the stream, with nothing to worry about except your early onset dementia wife and someone you are completely simping over. What to do? Oh my god, it's another Netflix sitcom! Halted, buddy. After we get under this log, do not keep going straight. There is going to be a right for us to take now. There it is, just up the mud path, so don't keep going straight. We're going to head up this little bit of hill right now. Job done. Hope you're enjoying your new Netflix sitcom, everyone. Have a look at this rope hook and stick it down. Stick it downtown to Brown Town. Canyon Town. What? So, we are going straight for the time being, because there's only straight to go. Unless you have the ability to climb on rocks, which you don't in this game. Head to the right when you see that big tree in front of you, and you can see the fence. So, make sure the fence is on your right-hand side, and we're going to see the gate that we can go through. So, we're going to pry that open with the axe, of course. If we didn't have the axe, we wouldn't be getting this far. Interact with the letterbox then, right in front of us. Wapiti. And we're going to get stung by a bee. No. Even though that would be pointless because the bee would die. Anyway, from here we're going left and sort of to the right till we get down these rocks right here. And we're going to jump over. We're going to get the achievement called Bee Plot. And you can report it if you want as well, because that hurt a little bee sting like you. Anyway, we're heading all the way down. I don't know why you would report a bee sting, because you're supposed to be rugged, manly. Bee stings don't hurt men. Yeah, no. Anyway, head to, we're just sticking with the left-hand side. You can see that big pole or whatever the hell that is, the generator on the left. Run past that, and just keep basically following the path for the time being. Until we get to this little bit of soily soil garden. And this little tent with a bunch of weird crap in it. So, just have a look at the hard case on the right-hand side. Pick up the wave receiver, and now you're probably thinking, what in the ball sack is going on right now? And when we're done loving that one, we can just go to the back, clear away this papery mess, pick up the black box, and this little cutscene is going to happen where, well and truly now, Henry and Delilah are going to crap their pants. Unfortunately. And by the way, where is the... We both live in like a lookout tower, but we got no toilet in there, so... Well, I suppose the wilderness is our crap shack. So... What we're going to do then, from here, there's going to be a long conversation. We can't actually sprint for now, but we're just going to go back the way we came. So yes, creepy stuff going on. Which, I mean, sort of towards the end of the game is where the game and the story gets really good, funnily enough. So head up the hill. It's a slow climb, but what we're going to do is start eventually just heading to the right. Again, we can see the generator just in front of us.
I didn't. This is insane. I'm so sick of letting these people do this to us. We should just burn the place down. Think about it.
Yeah, fuck them.
They'll dump an ocean of water on it, and these assholes will spend the rest of the summer picking up the pieces. We get to finish out our contracts. Hell, we'll even call in the fire.
Yeah, okay.
And it's a bit of a just straight stretch for now. Everything's slow, everything's chilled. Apart from us two, which are, who are being stalked to death, and, you know, it's a pretty shitty, scary situation. Not chocolate, sticky, or nutty, it's all bad nuts. So anyway, start heading to the right slightly. There we are, and then eventually what we're going to see is like a little jump across that we can jump across. And as soon as Henry and Delilah stop yammering on about being scared that somebody's stalking them and can kill them potentially... Then we can finally just go ahead, press A to jump over, and this little cutscene of almost death Henry happens. Don't get them bows caught in between two rocks, yo. You don't want to be chopping your nuts off to get out of there. Ouchie. Anyway, now we can see the column of smoke. This little bit of cutscene again with Delilah happens, but we can now turn around, go back through the gate. And then just take a look at the smoke, and that basically ends this part of the day. Wow, this is going just great. One summer you're here, Henry, and it's all going to shit.
And what about who started it? What about them?
The person who started it?
Yeah.
We're talking about people watching us out here who are now burning the forest and everything in it around us. I don't know what to do about that.
Except get the hell out.
Yes, get us the hell out of here.
I will.
So this is a continuation then of day 77. So straight out we can head out the door. Now you can use the wave receiver. Basically, we need to be finding whatever's beeping. And of course, when you get your wave receiver out, like you've seen earlier, it'll start blinking and going green when you're in the right direction, etc. But we're not going to bother with that. I'll just tell you where to go. Just makes life easier. So straight from the stairs, head left. Anyway, and we're just going to keep on going straight for this bit, past these bushes. Again, try and look at the environment. Just make sure that you're in the same place that I am. Should be okay. Just going straight for now. But we're going to go right here when we get to the sort of fork there. And we'll be heading down. Down, 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 down. And we are getting closer to it now. So head left now, just up this little bit of a bit of bush or whatever it is. And we're going to clear that bush. So make sure to get your 80s strimmer on the ready to get rid of that big old 80s bush. And we are going to interact with the strange backpack. Not once, but twice. Because goddamn, that just crapped your pants. So interact with it again. And we are going to get a key. Which, again, don't know if the person's done this on purpose. Otherwise, that's a pretty crappy place to leave a key. Although, I suppose without a wave receiver, you wouldn't be able to know that anyway, would you? So, that's what we're going to do. We're going to head towards the cave. So, a bit of slow action at the minute. We are just heading to the right and up this hill.
Camping gear, some clothes, you know, basics. But it was alarmed. I think that's what was making the receiver go haywire.
You're okay? It's not a trap or anything?
And then just straight through the trees and then go to the right rather than the left all the way up. Just go to the right here.
Shoshone National Forest, Cave 452. Is that the one in the canyon?
Yeah, it is. Who the hell took him?
See the fire in front of us, but don't go towards it. We're going to the left now. So turn to the left, right. Yeah. There we go. So we're still talking. So it's a nice slow bit of conversation again as we wonder if we're going to get pooped on by the stalker. I don't know if anyone's ever thought of that, but as you can see just in front of us anyway, we are by the lookout tower and that is where we are heading.
I am looking at a man standing in your lookout and it's not you.
It is not me.
Oh my God, go.
I'm going. Talking down at the site. It sounds like it was recorded from somewhere nearby.
Oh, Jesus.
Yeah, and it sounds like we were the ones who burned it down and that it was your idea.
No.
We are screwed.
No!
Dee, just don't freak out, okay? Don't freak out.
Oh my God, what the fuck is happening, Henry?
Whoopsie doodle. Well, as it turns out then, so we're being stalked, we're being pooped on by every stalker, the one stalker we've got, who has somehow gotten hold of our conversations and, well, I mean, he's pretty thorough, but I suppose if you're just stuck in the forest for a while, you've got nothing else to do, really. It's a bit boring. No TV, no games to play. What do you expect us to do all day? Eat leaves and poop on animals? No. So, day 77 is done. The fire is getting ever smokier, so heed my words carefully as we begin to do a little bit more exploring. So, head down. And what we're going to do is go to the right, ever so slightly, and again, you should come out in this tiny bit of open area. And again, with the rock directly in front of us, make sure to go around with the rock, hugging the rock on the left-hand side so we can do a little drop down, bloop. Bloop. Ah, one more drop down. And bloop. Not a problem for old steel cankles right there. Right, drop down, and again, just go to the left, over the bridge, etc., and all the way back down.
Consistent.
Yeah, I suppose you're right.
I know.
Hey, you... You didn't actually make that call, right? To the other lookout? It just stuck in my craw. I let myself imagine how fucked I would be if you'd been lying to me. But now that I asked, I kinda just wish I hadn't.
Of course I didn't. No way. They're trying to pit us against each other.
Yeah.
Of course it was me. I want to get to know you better. And that's probably actually happened. So anyway, dropping down to the cave, this time we are going through the weird gate. How has he got one particular gate for this key? I don't know. It must have been someone who works here, I assume. But I guess we're going to find out. So shove that open. Is it going to be a jump scare? No, there's not going to be a jump scare. So go to the left, and we're going to batter out these loose rocks. Ooga booga! No, there's genuinely no jump scare in the game, I promise. Squeeze it through, and there's basically only one particular path that we can go through at the minute.
It's freezing in here.
And that's the end of that chapter. So, first look through the cave, couldn't find anything weirdly, so make the long jump down. Again, don't worry, steel cankles will not feel it. And if we just head up ever so slightly, and underneath this rock to the left of us now, is a bunch of items that we can interact with. So you can really start to understand what the hell's going on with the story, and why we're looking for whoever we're looking for. But the only thing that we need is the things in the middle. What are they called? Pythons or something? Those things, yeah. They kind of look like scissors, half scissors or something, I don't know. But anyway, they're the ones that we particularly need. I do end up picking up a bunch of papers here as well, just to keep hold of it, just in case of any other story. I don't think it makes a difference, though. Picking up these papers and whatever, but you can have a look around, because a lot of it is actually quite interesting into the relation of who we're actually seeing, or trying to find, sorry. So go to the left, and we're going to climb up, and of course we're going to make the old drop down. As soon as we interact with the cracked rock, of course.
In regards to him being out here, you know, being against the rules. They almost got busted. Brian liked to go out on the railing of the tower and wave at the planes that dump water on fires, and...
So when we get down to the bottom then, go straight and then left here. There's a little fork, we're going to be going straight left. And then we're just heading basically straight as we listen to Delilah's story, which is... Well, we're starting to find out a little bit more about potentially who is after us. And who we're actually looking for. Maybe, who knows? It's a suspenseful game. So just keep heading straight for the time being.
Oh, also, those girls turned up. Looks like you didn't kill them. Nobody did. They took some farmer's tractor for a joyride down in Riverton, and,
when we're here, we're going to be turning left, as we just did. And, ah, oh, damn it. We're just going to head over this little bit of log. And we're just going to head into the... We're basically going into the opposite side of the cave to see if we can find anything, because we're only about 15-20 minutes away from the end of the game. So head right here so we can go back into the other gate to cave 452. Nyeh, nyeh, nyeh. Okay, heading in then. Again, it's quite a linear path. Nowhere that we can really go. So just follow the way that I do. Interact with the old crackle of rock. and get surprised by the boogerman. Okay, it's not a boogerman, but there is a surprise. For those that haven't played it, it is quite surpriseful. Okay, so, as it turns out then, Brian Goodwin was a child and either had his head caved in by accident or whoever he was with caved his head in and then put a bunch of rocks in it to make it look like an accidentio. Just go over these rocks, I don't know what I'm doing, being a bit of a dong-mong right there. But yeah, so we have found Brian Goodwin and it's not what everyone expected, since everyone thought he was just back in high school living his dream. But the only dream he's living is buying a stairway to heaven. If anyone doesn't get that reference, that is Led Zeppelin's song Stairway to Heaven. So I thought that was pretty good for me, actually. Anyway, again, just climb up and down all these rocks till we get outside and can give Delilah the great news that Brian finally bought his Stairway to Heaven.
Hey, Dee.
There you are. I've been worrying my ass off.
Hey, I'm sorry, Delilah. I'm so sorry.
About what? You're freaking me out.
He's in there.
What are you saying, Henry?
The only thing in the cave is Brian. He's dead. His body is in the cave, Delilah.
Gotta be fucking kidding me. How does that... What? I don't... How?
Climbing, I think, or made to look like a climbing accident.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know, maybe it was Ned.
If not him directly, he put enough stupid fucking know-how in his head to get him killed. Son of a bitch.
Yeah. I'm sorry, Delilah. I'm so sorry.
He'd be alive if I had told someone he was out here. I don't know where he'd be, but I can assure you it would not be rotting at the bottom of that cave. There's nothing to say. Hike back. I think we're leaving tomorrow anyway.
So, this is the final day that we're here. As you can see, the fire is completely ravaging us, so we are gonna have to get our complete white salty butt out of here. But not before, apparently Henry wants to go on one last adventure, so let's go ahead and do that. So we're heading down. At this point, your relationship with Delilah is pretty much done, and we haven't even met each other. Bit of a editing scene right here, as I messed up big time. So just go straight, past the sign and the rock on your left, And it might be a little bit hard to see, but just head slightly left through all these trees right here. And as you can see, we can just see this little bit of hill. We're going to go over. And then when we get down here, start going to the right. So we're going to start heading to the right slightly. And we're going to go straight past this little tree stump. And again, just keep going straight. And you shouldn't have any issues. Again, it can be a little bit confusing when you're trying to pick a dialogue response. It's so easy to get lost. So again, just go through these two rocks. This bit should seem very familiar to you now, even though it is kind of tricky to see, because more or less, you and Delilah started the fire, killed all the wildlife, proper Brickleberry style. Happy days. But yeah, just keep going straight for now.
Look, you should pack up everything you need in case we get the call and you can't come back.
Alright, look, if something happens,
I'll remember you.
Oh, well, that's nice. Nope.
What's your status?
I think.
So now we are at the bottom right here. What we're going to do, just keep on hugging the sort of right-hand side of the big sort of rocks on your right. So head right now. So we're going up this little sort of mud path. And things are starting to get better. The wave thing's going nuts, because here is the cassette tape with our name very freakishly all chalked in and everything. And when we're here, then, we are going to have to keep on going. And eventually, when Delilah stops talking, we can listen to the tape. But head down and more or less just go straight in our general direction. And eventually, and basically the next tape is, here we go. It's more or less a confession tape now. But when we get here, instead of going left under the log, go to the right slightly and clear the bush. There's a bush that we need to clear. Or a block trail or whatever. It was basically directly straight in front of you. But instead of going left under the log, go this way. And job's your nan's uncle's mum. Maybe slightly confusing this bit, but if you just go straight a little bit and then turn directly around to the right, see this big log in front of us, and there is just a big stream that... just go past it. There's a big stream that we can follow.
Delilah. She's a record you don't gotta flip. I kinda get why Brian took to her. About a week ago, I stopped worrying about you finding anything out, and that's right when everything went shithouse with you two. You guys don't know anything about having kids. All right, nobody knows nothing. It ain't Andy and Opie walking down a lake to fish every afternoon. It ain't Mayberry. But you gotta know I didn't kill him. All right, we were climbing. I was teaching him. Brian was uneducated in the way to do anything. He just fucking didn't sink his anchor the right way. You know, I thought about going back, having to answer questions and having to get him put in the ground, and I didn't see the point. Don't come looking for me. Sorry about your wife.
We found the surveillance operation.
Okay, what does that mean? What is it?
It was Ned Goodwin. He was the one listening to us, just him.
Ned Goodwin? He made the tape?
Yeah.
So this Dad of the Year award then. Sorry you died, Brian, but I'll just leave you there. Just waiting for someone else to find you instead. Yeah, cheers, Dad. Complete bell end. Anyway, when we get to this part, just keep going straight and then we're going to head down to the right. There's a fork. We can go left or right. We're going down to the right. Again, we are coming up to the end of the game. We've got literally about 5 minutes or so now. So just head up this little part of hill. What we need to do is get to Thoroughfare Lookout. Look out, Brian Goodwin. You're dead, but your dad doesn't want to come back and pick you up. For some reason, he just left you there. Dad of the Year Award, buddy! Yeah, it's not a good look, really, is it? Anyway, keep on heading up. And then eventually we should get to this point. You can probably just see the sign in front of us. There it is. We can see it. So just keep on. What we're going to do is go slightly left, but more or less straight. So straight with a bit of slight left. Hop on over the log. Don't blame me, Sam, bitch. And then go right. We're going right. And then straight down the hill. Although, yeah, to be fair, she is right. You would just tell someone, oh, look, my son's dead in there. Can you just go in and grab him? This is just more or less a straight... straight as you can get for the time being. Heading up the left there and coming up and climbing up here. And eventually we are going to get to a point where... which may seem very familiar. So what you need to do is just sort, again, sort of stick to the left side. We're going to be coming up to a block trail. Here it is. That's why you needed to go sort of slightly left again.
Okay, 1 second.
Basically, she's going to flub us off. So, yeah, cheers for that, Del. That bitch. Anyway, just keep going straight again. This path is pretty linear. Again, you can say go or wait. I choose to say wait because... Delilah, we've shared many a... touchy-touchies with each other without actually being with each other. Anyway, where those two signs are, we're going to be heading to the right of where we just dropped down. So the way with all the trees. So head that way. And now, what we're going to see then is the fences where you can either go left or right. To get to where we need to go to the right. Again, there is more conversation with Delilah, but I chose to edit it out because I actually made a mistake and fudged it up. So keep going up and all the way straight and you should finally see the cable cart that the cable car that we can nip down on. And there we have it then. So we are back home. Apparently this fire has destroyed some of the stairs and they turn into rock. Well, either way to get up anyway. But this is basically now the end of the game. So all you need to do, turn left when we get back into the lookout. Interact with the radio headset and there's going to be a long conversation. And I'm just going to say it out now. I did not like this ending. I did not like this ending. I kind of wish... that the developers kind of made it so that the choices actually mattered. So at the end of the game, this big final conversation, you had a choice to either go with Delilah or go and see Julia. And there was a maybe a cutscene where, you know, a little happy cutscene or something. But I kind of do wish that the choices did matter because whatever you pick, it's always going to end up the same way. And we never see Delilah again. And after all those 79 days of... simping and being completely horny without actually knowing what each other looks like, it's kind of a sad and disappointing and bittersweet way to end. So who knows, maybe there'll be a Firewatch 2, there'll be something sort of similar to this and we actually get happy endings and choices and dialogues do matter. That would have made this game even better, but you know, still can't beat it. But anyway, smash through the dialogue options for now. This is basically the end of the game.
Me neither. I don't know what's next.
Tell you what, why don't you choose for me and I'll choose for you?
All right, sure. Maybe... maybe you could come back to Boulder with me and figure it out down there. Just a thought.
You don't want me down there.
Well, I just asked you.
Look, I've got some things to do in Casper, and maybe I'll head south sometime after that. I could come by, sure.
Okay. So, what about me?
I think you should go to Julia, and then you can figure it out. Maybe put that typewriter to good use. Give me a sexy accent or something if you write about this.
Yeah.
You gotta go see her.
Would you?
Henry, I... Look, you came out to put your memories behind you, and they're still right there in front of you.
I gotta move on. I don't expect you to know what that's like, but I have to find some way to move on. Something to do.
What if you can't?
Then maybe they're hiring lookouts in the Adirondacks.
I don't believe that for a second.
I gotta move on. Somehow.
I hope you do.
There's the helicopter.
They'll land you back where you hiked up. Good luck, Henry.
Right, so third time I played through this, and honestly, that ending, after going through all that together, pork pond, hilarious, but going through that ending just for it to end like that is highly, highly disappointing. But there we go then, so all we got to do, follow the helicopter. It's basically just straight down and ever so slightly to the left. If you manage to miss the helicopter, then my friend, you must be blind, or just, you know, a bit dumb, like me. Because I almost missed it the first time. I kept trying to go straight instead of left. What a fool. But there we go then, guys and gals. So that is Firewatch. Again, this has been out for what? 5 years? 5.5 years now? So it's been a while. But with it being on Game Pass, hopefully there's a lot of new players who've experienced this game. And with that, I do hope that you have enjoyed the game. For anyone new playing it, I hope you enjoyed the guide as well and that it helped. If you did, of course, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and share with a friend as well. Don't forget to check me out on all my socials, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and Patreon. And again, a big, huge, massive shout out to everyone who continues to support the channel on Patreon. You guys and gals are just legendary. And that'll be that then, guys and gals. So, until the next Game Pass game, I'll see you then. Big love.